It's a fireball?
Honey whiskey.
It's honey whiskey.
Take your shirt off.
All right.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Maybe.
Oh, my God. My virgin eyes.
Messy.
Hey, guys.
That Kaitlin beneficiary,
Penn State gun girl
person is weird.
She's weird.
She's very weird.
Am I now consequently giving her clout by making a video about her?
Yeah, I never said I was above anybody.
And I really didn't want to give her that much energy, so I grabbed the first two things I can find in my drawer.
And yes, I have a Britney t-shirt.
Here she is.
It's been a while. I know I shouldn't have kept you waiting. But I'm here now. Can you take this? I know
Britney Spears.
Getting ready to talk about some gun girlness. You
know, maybe she's for the gun girl. We don't know Britney Spears' life.
All the boys and all the girls are begging to if you seek a gun. I'm a slave for weapons.
It got me.
Who is Penn State gun girl?
She is
a person
that is doing stuff on the internet.
I don't even know.
She like posted pictures of her like
posing with like guns
as like graduation photos, and that like of course like Twitter sphere people got mad about it.
Gave her some clout.
She kept on going down that train and did like other stuff, and now people got more mad at that.
And now she's like saying shit that makes like no sense.
And now she has like a YouTube channel
interview thing where she like goes around and asks people random questions
and
they exist online. That's all I know.
A lot of people requested me make a video about this. I was very hesitant, but then at the same time,
let's get those views, bitch. You know, let's get those views.
She was going viral on Twitter like
multiple occasions.
Why not cash grab on that?
I'm not above it, bitch.
She'll like post like
random things on Twitter and it will cause like a
storm of bullshit.
She'll just be standing in the snow with a gun
for no reason.
And the caps will be like, fuck you, global warming or some shit.
She'll be trending on Twitter for like 2 seconds.
I wish I had that power.
Like, I wish I was given that opportunity.
What am I doing wrong? You know?
People spend their time like posting and making these tweets
feeling like they're being better than the person they're tweeting about.
But in reality, all you're doing is feeding into who that person is.
Stop trying to feel better than people.
Let's do that.
Stop trying to feel better than people
and just like walk away.
So are you warming up yet?
She has videos on the internet and today I'm going to watch them.
Yay.
Are you ready, Brittany?
I know I may be young, but I've got feelings too. And I need to do what I feel like doing. So let me go and just listen.
Great. And then apparently she like shit herself in college. I don't know what happened there. Brittany said that. That wasn't me.
Brittany, shut up.
Girl, you saying too much.
Liberty Hangout. What?
I'm really not a fan of those political channels.
Politics in general just makes me so anxious.
So negative 24/7 in the political sphere. So I'm just like always just like ill.
I'm the type of bitch to just like to slide in for 2 seconds, be like, y'all sure? And then slide out.
You know,
keep my peace,
keep my sanity,
enjoy my life.
Slide back in.
I don't know. And then slide back out. That's it. That's me.
Let's do this one. College students have no moral.
It is 20 minutes.
I don't know.
We couldn't make it like 5 or some shit. Do I really have to listen to you for that fucking long?
I'm sorry. That was rude. That was Brittany.
Brittany!
Girl, you wildin'. She's just saying shit.
Here we go.
20 minute long video that I'm not gonna watch all the way through because fuck you.
Fuck you. Brittany!
What do you think about starting an initiative on campus here at UK to be more inclusive to women who have penises? We can put urinals in the women's restroom for them.
Sounds fantastic.
Oh, does it?
Yeah.
Okay. Is she really going around asking college students this? Why?
Why are college students caring about this?
Okay.
Wait a minute.
Is the video her just walking around asking them about urinals?
When I was in college, bitch, the last thing I gave a fuck about
was what the hell was happening in my bathroom.
Let's take it one step closer. You know, more for inclusivity here on campus, but free tampons and pads in the men's restroom for men who have periods.
Sounds great.
Okay. You'll see anything wrong with those statements?
No.
No!
Wait, is there something wrong with these statements? What's happening here?
Is it 20 minutes of this?
Guys, is it 20 minutes of this? Guys, I don't know if I can do this video.
I think I might turn it off right here and just like go sleep.
I can't sit here for 20 minutes
listening to her ask people. Let's just keep on going.
What men do you know with periods?
Ooh. Wow. I mean, I know a few in my passing, but I might just be special. I don't know.
I don't even know how y'all do that. Okay, let's talk about periods for a second.
Fuck this girl.
Brittany! How do y'all, like, periods? How, like, why do you let that happen? Like, I know you have to.
But, like, damn.
You're telling me that, like, one day I can just wake up and be like, aw, shit.
My bed is covered in blood.
Aw, damn.
Blood is just pouring out of my body.
Like an exhaust pipe, bitch.
When your egg seriously was like, bitch,
I'm leaving.
Bye.
But couldn't leave by itself. It had to take a whole ass part of you with it. Like, what?
Humans are weird.
Let's just talk about the absolute chaos the human body is.
Rather than a $20 fucking box of tampons.
I don't give a shit.
Put a urinal in a woman's bathroom.
Most of them probably look at it and be like, what the fuck is that?
In my entire life, I've probably only seen a tampon dispensary machine like 3 times.
But I will not lie. If they do put one of those in a man's bathroom, I might try it out and like see how it works and how it dispenses the bitch.
But other than that,
I don't care. It's not for me.
Unless I have a nosebleed, then maybe.
30 seconds in, by the way.
What do you think about putting urinals in the women's restroom for women who have penises?
That's fine.
Actually, how about we just like
delete urinals in general? Honestly,
who needs that?
Like, that's a weird... Why are we still doing that, you know?
I understand it does save water, but at the same time,
just think about
it. The urinal experience is like the weirdest thing.
No one's fully comfortable standing at a urinal.
That's just the sacrifices we have to do.
The sacrifices we have to take.
Standing next to a complete random stranger with your dick hanging out,
peeing on a wall.
Basically what urinals are.
Prove me wrong.
Anyone can pee against the wall.
People with vaginas can do it too.
Y'all just gotta position yourself and squirt harder. 50 seconds in. I'm just gonna quit this video now.
We're not gonna get through it.
We're finished with that one.
I don't know.
She's going around the street asking people what they feel about adding urinals to the women's bathrooms and tampon and pad dispensers
to the men's bathroom.
And everyone's being like, I literally don't give a shit.
And then she responds with,
oh wow, really? Oh my god.
That's literally the video for like 20 minutes.
And then she tried to do a comeback being like,
oh, but like, what about the tax dollars?
Tax dollars, bitch.
Didn't we just spend $1 trillion that we don't have on something called a space force?
But buying urinals is where we draw the fucking line.
Okay, I'm gonna do one video full.
College students have no morals one. I couldn't.
Really thought you can walk around a college campus and talk to college kids about something they literally don't give a shit about.
College kids, right now.
Y'all care about your bathroom?
Y'all probably paying like $50,000 a year.
I'm not gonna be paying attention to what the fuck's happening in my bathroom, bitch. I'm trying to get my money's worth.
Honestly, if there's enough kids that need that shit, they're paying enough fucking money to go to that school to fucking deserve it, you know?
And I'm not gonna stop them.
She also uploaded a video called Pride Gets Peace.
Let's watch that one instead. It's 18 minutes, so maybe I can stomach it. You know, 2 minutes less.
Oop. So there's some people that are figuring me out. They're very scared. Her supporters are behind her right now calling me a b-.
Is this what the video all is? It's just people cussing her out? I mean, go ahead, go on.
Pride gets peaceful.
Okay, first of all, let's talk about that.
Literally, the history of Pride started off of a riot.
We tried to be peaceful. We tried to be peaceful. We were going to our little clubs, going to little congregations. Whenever we met up, the police were knocking on our door being like, bitch, you can't do this. So we were tired and we caused the ruckus.
It wasn't until we started getting very loud and chaotic
where people like,
oh, maybe they should have rights.
And that's just the country we live on.
That was not peaceful. Let's get that started. Pride was never peaceful.
Maybe it's a little bit now. It's calmed down. We're chill a bit.
These are her supporters. These are her supporters acting like this. Can you believe that? There's a child dancing over there. Holy shit, that's disgusting.
There's a child dancing.
Oh no, that's gross.
Just call them disgusting? Wow.
I see you're acting very progressive and very tolerant right now. Why do you behave in that type of way?
Are you kidding me right now, girl?
I can't watch this either. You see me, I'm just being so silent. I'm really trying to do this video, but I can't do it, guys. I can't do it. 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 I can't do it.
I can't do it.
I can't do it.
I can't do it.
I just can't do it.
I can't do it.
I can't do it.
I can't do it.
I really don't like people that like to pretend like they're above somebody else.
I've said this
so many times before.
In these videos,
she's just acting above these people.
It's like this edit compilation
to make her seem above
these people
to like her alt-right troopies.
I don't fucking know.
My biggest pet peeve is people that think they're better than other people.
So I just can't sit through a video
of her trying to act all high and mighty
above my fellow queers,
my fellow
Pajots.
You know what I mean?
I tried. I tried for you guys. You guys asked. I really tried.
I'm still probably gonna upload this video, bitch.
I really tried, but I really cannot.
My biggest pet peeve.
I can't sit through that.
First of all, it's terribly edited.
Second of all,
20 minutes long, bitch.
I don't have the time.
I tweeted this video idea out, people, and a lot of you guys even warned me that I probably wouldn't be able to watch through it.
Y'all know me.
You know what? As an American, I honestly do not care about any other part of the world. This is...
I don't believe.
She's a troll.
That's it.
That's the moral of this story. I can't believe that. I can't believe that. Like, that can't be a real person.
That's a troll.
That is a troll if I've seen one.
She is a college-educated woman.
She cannot be that ignorant.
She is a troll.
She's making that money. That's all I believe.
If that's the truth.
You know, a bitch cannot deny a hustle.
Like, I want to so bad be like, stop, don't do that. But, like, at the same time, we're all going to top.
Let's make this check real quick. You know what I mean?
I refuse to believe this is a real person.
Maybe she did shit herself in college. I don't know. Maybe that was a troll move too, bitch.
Maybe she's been about that hustle since the first turd. I don't know.
We don't know her.
I can't believe this is real.
But you have gun control.
Yes.
That's terrible. I don't want to live there.
She has to be fed.
Oh my God.
I can't.
I'm done. I tried. I'm done.
What I'm seeing in these videos
is just like
no conversation.
These videos were purposely edited so she can make herself
look above people.
And then people are responding to her, trying to be above her.
Moral of the story,
no human is above another human being.
We can't have proper conversations with each other if we go in automatically thinking we're better than another person.
That doesn't solve shit.
Genuine conversations and genuine solutions cannot be formed if you just throw people away.
And when you think you're better than someone, you're literally throwing them away.
She's making me feel weird.
Penn State girl. What else do we know about her?
She likes guns.
No, duh.
She got married, I think. I don't know.
Shat herself, apparently. I don't know.
I keep on bringing this up.
Once again, I'm not better than anybody.
Brittany!
I'm so sorry.
I'm not giving you guys more.
But I literally, like, mentally cannot do this.
People have different opinions on and things all over the goddamn rock.
And some of the opinions are just
so terrible and bad.
But you can't just throw them away off of that fact alone.
Especially now that we live in a time where anybody
can gain any amount of power or following for no reason.
You can't throw away someone's opinion anymore.
Instead of throwing someone away, you have to understand that person.
Because the situation cannot truly be solved unless you understand multiple perspectives of it.
I feel like we all just tend to forget that we're all just human beings with opinions that are just trying to live.
Some people's opinions are just very, 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 very.
You know,
just completely throwing those people, those opinions away doesn't solve anything.
The opinions still exist, they still circulate, nothing solved, questions are never answered.
You're just leaving the pot on a low simmer.
It might not be bubbling that fast, but bitch, it's still getting hot.
Cancel culture, let's stop canceling people and just get to the bottom of people.
Cancel culture
is now
bottoming culture.
Brittany!
Was this entire video to lead up to a bottoming joke?
No.
But did I make it? Maybe.
Shout out to @FushiJam and @RizzyCosplay for retweeting me on Twitter.
Comment down below
if you were to shit yourself at a party.
How would you cover it up?
Is that rude? What's that rude?
Brittany!
Last time I asked you guys in my 27-minute long ass
video, goddamn.
I'm sorry.
Last time I asked you guys,
what would you do if Oprah emailed you?
Kenzie Mason said, bitch, if Oprah emailed me, I quit university, start writing a will, and buy a coffin with the last of my student loan because my life would be fulfilled.
Cute.
Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm gonna go question my life choices.
My name is Mac, and don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe, babe. Woo!
I see you, and I just want to dance with you.